we went further than any monk or scientist before us. We fused the erratic nature of alchemy with the rigid principles of science. We had developed a profound power, the verve, capable of producing miracles, but also forceful enough to create calamity in the wrong hands. We decided never to touch it again. My wagon must be somewhere close. I must find it.
Welcome to episode 2 of Chronology. I'm your host, Lostwolfe. And last time we had sort of, you know, jumped and run around for a bit. So here's another one of those puzzles where you basically have to go real fast. Okay. Let's see now. I need to get...
Oh, that poor thirsty guy. He looks like he's about to kick the bucket.
And again, that's sort of an oral clue. I need to go there, and then there. Alright, let's pick up the bucket. As I say, generally you do something in the past and that affects the future. If we put the bucket down or we go look at the sky, as he noted that that guy was thirsty and he died due to, you know, lack of water. But if you go into the past and you give him water... He looks much happier now. And he is quite large. So, one of the things that you can do is you can hop on his vines to get across.
That alloy metal shell might work as a stepping stone.
And it will do that because, of course, we can't get up here. So what we're going to do is, it's not patently obvious, but if you hop this way, he will tilt to the left. If you hop this way, he will tilt to the right. We need to get him such that he can fire a little shell thing. We need to get it such that he will hit the shell with his projectile, like so.
Why the long face, snail? The snail creature is completely in pieces. She looks like she has lost her shell.
And now, of course, she wants her shell. So again, recall that if I grab this, I can take it to the past with me. And that's great, because as we've seen, we can grow things in the past. So we're going to put this down for a second, grab the shell so it's not quite in the way, and so that I can always reach it. Did I really do that? There we go. I think I can put it down there. Pick up the shell. Pick up the plant. Pick up the pasta. Stick it down there and we should be good. Yeah, we should be good. Okay, so now what we can do is we can switch between the snail and...
You can talk.
Huh, you can hear? Get on my back, old man.
We can switch between the snail and the old man. And the great thing is that you can use the snail to carry the old man around. That should be about right. So let's hop there.
Hey, wait, don't leave me! Call me?
So you can call the snail and the snail will come to you.
You can always whistle and I'll come running.
Maybe you could reach that button for me.
Okay, so one thing that the snail can do that the man can't is he can go on surfaces because his slimy exterior sticks to them. Which is great.
Yeah, boy.
Pick me, pick me! I have something cool to show you!
Okay, so like the man, the snail has a particular little power that he can do. If he hit B, he will stop time.
Did you just stop time, snail?
Yup. I was engineered that way.
Okay, and I can hop that way and hop that way. Let me see if I remember this. Hey. First of all, let's get snail this way. And oh right, okay. There.
How do I get up there?
You can always call a friend.
You can always call a friend.
Come here.
Okay, so we need to go back to the past. Let me see now. I should do it. Oh, I need the snail over here. Okay. Oh, goodness. We can head over here. Now, the thing about this is that if you have the snail on top of that, it will go up. This is a bit of a problem because that's continually turning, but it's really not a big problem because you can always use the snail to stop it completely. We're just going to make this little section a little bit easier. Find the right time there. Okay. Oops, there's a snail here. Oops. I only do a lot of that. Up we go. And now, oh, hold on. I may as well not be there because this is going to kill me if I'm not. If you notice in the future, there's a little grass pit there. So what we obviously need to do is jump from here to there. And while we're in there, we'll do that. Jump across. I love the little puzzles like this. They're really interesting. That's a great way to kind of do the puzzle solving.
My wagon? What happened?
That scrap pile is your wagon?
Shut up, snail. Let's just get a move on.
That's not very nice.
I need someone who can give me some answers.
My mentor betrayed my trust. Behind my back, he made a deal to develop the Verve further in his own lab in the Metropolis.
I knew the consequences could be fatal, but I walked away without saying a word. I became a drifter.
Slow down! You can't keep running from your past!
Keep your cliches in your shell, snail. My mentor might have betrayed me, but he's the only lead I have. Let's get to higher ground so we can find a way to the Metropolis.
So this chapter, unfortunately, Elevated Resolve, as one of the very few interactions between the man and the snail that I'm not really crazy about. It's completely unwarranted, and I didn't like it the first time I saw it. I don't like it now. So, eh. It is what it is. It's not great, but there we go. Okay, so we're gonna hop on up here. Why am I stopping time? Well, because if I speed time up again, I will not be able to get up here. This will be continually straight up in the air, and I won't be able to do anything about it. But as long as I'm on here and the snail stop time, I can happily go forward.
Yeah.
Huh, good thinking. How did you get so clever?
How did you get so annoying?
There we go. I don't like that interaction. There's a further interaction here that I'm not too crazy about.
Hey. Yeah.
I need to get up there.
Things aren't so bad.
Things aren't bad, huh? I've had it with you, Snail. I didn't ask for your company. Now leave me alone.
And that is the interaction I'm not crazy about. No, you can't call the snail at all, because the old man is, you know, not real happy with him.
At least he doesn't jabber all the time.
Okay, so he's looking for mushrooms. There are two mushrooms here, and the mushroom you pick influences him in the future. If I pick, for example, this mushroom, which has got a flat top, and I feed it to him, if I go into the future, he will be a flat-topped beastie. If I go back into the past and grab this, but I feed him this, he will have more of a triangular upright shape, which is great because I can use that to get up here. I think I need, where do I need the box? I need the box there, but I need to do it in the past, in the future. Let's drop that here. Grab his mushroom that he's munching on. Now, because in this particular version of the future he's flat, it's much easier to make this jump. Oh, goodness. I'm gonna do that a lot. Oh, goodness. I need that there because I want to go across here. This is one of the sort of frustrating bits of platforming. It's not difficult, but it is a little bit awkward because you don't have a snail, so. That one's okay, this one is less so. Oh lord. See if I can make it now. Oh no. There we go. Oh, no. Let's go around again and now. There we are.
A bit too hard on the snail.
Snail to the rescue!
And again, I don't like that he sighs like that. The snail didn't do anything to him to warrant that sort of behavior. There we go. Now it's a lot easier, of course, because you got the snail on, so you can freeze time and do the jumps. Oh, this is... I love this. Let's pull the snail. Oh, right. Oh, I should actually show you that. There are sections where you can't call the snail, where you've got that big snail thing on top there. That means the snail can't go with you.
I can't summon snails here.
So... let's start time. This is simple enough. Alright, we need a snail to get up there. Okay, now it's probably technically possible to make it through there, but it's a lot easier if you just do this. Now. And you run through.
Hey.
Oh goodness, hold on. This section is a bit convoluted because you need to know that in order to reach the platform on your left, which you can't actually do through jumping because otherwise you'd die, you have to get the snail onto the right hand side.
Come here.
Right, oh. I need you again, sorry. I made a mistake. And we can get him to go down here. Which is perfect for jumping onto. And you can probably go down a tiny fraction more. There's a little corkscrew thing there, which I want to grab. And head on back up. It's difficult to see when they're on top of each other. So there's a... this is unfortunate. There are a couple of things that the old man does that I'm not wild about in this game. This is one of those very unfortunate things. If you don't like rat killing, stop watching now. So if you have the time unfrozen, this rat thing will run into here, making it impossible for you to do anything. This little gizmo here is running, and if you go, actually I'll just show you, because it will make more sense. Let's put this down there. The rat thing is currently dead, and there's no machine here because the machine worked obviously in the past and was fine. We need to go back here. Now you can see he goes in there, and now I can't do anything with it. I want this rat thing to go in there and to destroy the mechanism. Well, the easiest way to do that is to get out of there.
The mouse that has but one hole is quickly taken.
Oh man, I'm sorry about mouse guy.
Come here.
If we go into the future now, we can see that we got a bunch of broken junk here.
The regret you were running from. Why don't you just use your time machine to go back and change it?
Of course. We'll go to the Metropolis and stop my mentor from ever abusing the Verve.
Snail, you are a genius.
I'm so glad they met up. Oh yes, that's right. We need to get to the top. There we go. That's sort of perfect right now. I need to get up there, and to do that we need to do this, and then that, oh, this. There we go.
Hey.
Grab the snail, put it over there. And again, it's like a little cannon thing. So, stop time, pull the snail over, and hop on top. Right, this is where I'm going to leave you. We will see this cutscene when I see you again on Friday. Thank you so much for watching Chronology. I've been your host, lostwolfe. This has been episode 2. I hope you're enjoying this as much as I'm enjoying playing it for you. I will be seeing you soon. Have a great 2 days, folks, and goodbye.
Hey, Snail! We're off to save the world!